Outdoor enthusiasts who are anywhere but moderate dry climates will need a quiver of jackets to keep comfortable throughout the year. Jacket technology is abundant, with new designs coming out all the time with added features and improvements. Rain jacket is somewhat ambiguous as a term in the outdoor industry because many jackets will keep the user dry. But we're referring to them as the lighter weight shells on the market, which are usually 2.5 or 3-ply technology. These jackets are lightweight, breathable, and of course, waterproof. The face fabric is designed to be lighter weight, and they should be coated in high-quality water repellent. This water repellent, or DWR, is responsible for the water beading off the jacket. Rain jackets are designed to allow moisture to exit through the jacket, reducing the clammy feeling made famous by that yellow PVC rain jacket. There are two main options, either laminate or coatings. Laminate jackets are more durable and have better breathability, but are heavier and more expensive than coated jackets. Next, we've got technical shells. We're referring to those used throughout the four seasons. These are usually 3-ply jackets. The face fabric or outer material is sturdy for use in many conditions, including climbing, skiing, hiking, backpacking, camping, and others. For skiing and snowboarding, choose a jacket with a powder skirt and buy it large enough to fit over your insulating layers. Shells are not designed for insulation, but to keep the water and wind out and away from you. Pit zips are really, really important to make sure that you're going to be keeping cool. And if you'll be wearing a pack, make sure the pockets are accessible even when you have that pack on. Climbers will want the jacket to have a high rise in the front to help the fit with a harness on. Climbers and others wearing helmets will want jackets with a big hood, which is able to fit over a helmet. When rain isn't likely in the forecast, but your activity is high output, also known as sweaty, soft shells are a category of jacket which outperform technical shells and rain jackets in all but heavy downpours. These jackets are wind resistant and water resistant. They're really durable because they're polyester instead of nylon, and they stretch rather than ripping. They come in different thicknesses, which will provide more or less insulation depending on your activity and where you're going to be working out. For high output activities, the breathability of these jackets paired with the warmth makes them a very, very desirable option. For high output activities when the weather is getting a little bit on the colder side, you can get a polyfill jacket. The outer material is usually nylon with a polyester fill. They're very breathable and they're usually windproof. They also work really well as an outer layer or as an insulating layer under a shell. The nylon outer material is typically not very resistant to rips and punctures, so you want to be careful. For lower output activities, down is a very good natural material. Down provides one of the best warmth to weight ratios, though it doesn't allow moisture to pass through. When down gets wet, it loses its ability to insulate. Down jackets and vests are most common. They're a great item to bring you with you when you're going to be doing a lot of standing around, such as your winter camping or ice climbing when you're doing belays. Another option includes down sweaters. They have small baffles and are not nearly as thick as down jackets. They work well as a layering piece with low output activities. Fleece jackets are great for many activities as an outer layer and an insulating layer. Unless it's a soft shell fleece or has another face fabric, most fleece is not windproof and it's not going to do very well in windy conditions. Ski and snowboard jackets are designed to provide both insulation and waterproofing all in a single jacket. These can either be a shell with a zip-in liner or a complete package. These jackets are really good for front country skiers and boarders, but for high output, they're not very adjustable to different conditions and output activities.